The Massachusetts Institute of Technology is a place filled with important, groundbreaking work being done by extraordinary people. Inventors, innovators, scientists, economists, Nobel laureates, and brilliant students devoted to solving the most pressing issues of our time. While they all shine bright, one has been shining a lot longer than most. 99-year-old neuroscientist Sid Diamond is a researcher in Pawan Sinha's lab, a position he landed after retiring from a long career at Mount Sinai Hospital as an academic neurologist on the faculty of the Mount Sinai School of Medicine and the director of the Clinical Neurophysiology Lab. Before his time at Mount Sinai, Sid attended medical school in New York City. Prior to that, he served as a paratrooper in World War II. And even before that, he was recognized as a promising young musician at Oberlin Conservatory of Music. At 99, Sid may very well be the oldest active researcher at MIT. Work in the Sinha lab focuses on understanding how the brain processes sensory signals, with a particular emphasis on brain development and visual learning. In 2005, Pawan Sinha launched an initiative called Project Prakash, aimed at providing medical treatment to blind and visually impaired children in India. In 2007, Sid became aware of the groundbreaking work being done in the Sinha lab at MIT and was eager to be a part of it.
Once you provide the fundamentals of vision, we can study how their brains develop, and that contributes to our knowledge of what the brains are trying to do.
If you have, say, a 10-year-old who has been blind from birth, and then surgically you can initiate sight in this child, then from the very moment that the bandages are opened after the surgery, you can begin to learn about how this child is developing his or her visual abilities, perhaps even how the brain is changing in response to the visual input.
It's remarkable. We get insights that we cannot possibly get from normal infants because they can't respond.
It's really, really nice that this project allows us to address, I would say, the holy grail kind of question of neuroscience, and that is, in the words of William James, how does the brain transform a blooming, buzzing confusion into something that's meaningful?
For those who work in the Sinha lab, Sid is much more than a fellow researcher with decades of experience. He's a cherished friend and colleague, celebrated for his extraordinary kindness, unique mentorship, and a spark for life that shows no sign of dimming.
I remember when I first met Sid in lab here, I was like, oh my God, at this age, he is coming to lab every day with that energy and that active in the work he's doing like that. Like, it's so inspiring for me.
There are so many facets of Sid that I admire. I mean, he's absolutely the person who we can all look up to, get inspired by.
He just wants to live forever because there's so much to figure out and learn and do.
Sid strikes me as an embodiment of the ideal that we want scientists to have. The ideal of pursuing science for the sake of pursuing science, not just for the sake of furthering one's own profile, one's own career. The driving goal has to be the passion for science, the passion for solving big problems. And Sid captures that spirit so beautifully, and I've tried to imbibe that in my own life.
So what's Sid's secret to healthy and functioning longevity?
I don't know. I could have done other things, but from childhood, I needed to know. I thought that on my deathbed, I would have no more questions yet to ask. And of course, when I grew up, I faced the fact that the very nature of the world of science, there is no end, there is no final answer. But the thing that you have the responsibility to learn as much as you can about the things that interest you.
At 99, Sid shows no signs of slowing down. Instead, he remains focused on tackling big problems and helping as many people as he can along the way. In the field of neuroscience and brain function, Sid is not only a respected scientist and researcher, but also an inspiring example. One can't help but wonder if the secret to his longevity is that after a lifetime dedicated to studying the workings of the mind, Sid has never forgotten the importance of the heart.